教皇様が間もなく会場に到着されます。聖歌あなたの平和の歌います。皆様ご起立ください。
Schedule. The Holy Father has just arrived here. You can hear the applause for the Holy Father's arrival. At Sophia University. Sophia University is a school that was founded by the Jesuits just over 100 years ago in 1913. And it is certainly very prominent and well-respected university. As we mentioned, this is the Holy Father's final main public event this morning. And he is being welcomed here today. We are also going to hear from Sukuma Tsutomo, the Chancellor of the Sophia School Corporation, which includes not only the university, but also a number of other associated academic institutions.
Lo que aquí están es solamente una partecita pequeña. Bueno, pudo ver afuera también que hay muchos chicos. Es el lugar más grande que tenemos en la universidad, pero creo que el 10% nomás de los que querían entrar, entraron. Así que le agradecemos muchísimo. Vamos a comenzar la ceremonia con unas palabras del canciller de la universidad, el profesor, el padre Sukuma Tsutomo.
And here we will have the Chancellor Sukuma Tsutomo, who will greet the Holy Father.
Holy Father, good morning. On behalf of the Sophia family, welcome to Sophia University. As a Catholic university founded by Jesuits in Japan, Sophia is greatly honored today with Your Holiness' presence. 2 years ago, when we connected this venue and the Vatican using a video conference system in the event Let's Talk with the Pope Francis. We are deeply grateful to Your Holiness for answering each question made by our students most graciously. It is a great joy for me to have been granted the opportunity to thank you in person. As we all know, the origin of Sophia University can be traced back to the dream that St. Francis Xavier had when he came to Japan in 1549 as a missionary to have a higher educational institution in Japan. The dream was actualized only in 1913 when three Jesuit priests arrived in Japan, commissioned by Pope St. Pius X in 1908. This also became the second visit by Jesuits to Japan. The university celebrated its centennial in 2013, the year Your Holiness became Pope. We are blessed with Your Holiness' visit after 38 years since the visit made by Pope St. John Paul II to Sophia University. Sophia has now a university, a junior college, a school of social welfare, and four secondary schools under the school corporation. We acknowledge and are privileged to have Facultas Ecclesiastica in the Faculty of Theology and Philosophy. Let me take this opportunity to extend our deep gratitude and appreciation for entrusting us with this mission. Let me take this opportunity to thank you, Your Holiness, for sending Jesuits from Argentina to Japan. One of them is our present provincial, and another one is our MC today. Catholic education in today's secularized context is a challenge everywhere. However, as a Jesuit institution, we are aware of the four universal apostolic preferences of the Society of Jesus announced early this year and approved by Your Holiness. While accompanying young people in the creation of a hope-filled future, as provided by one of these preferences, Sophia is committed as a responsible academic institution to engage in the other three preferences as well, namely to promote discernment in prayer and to work for vulnerable people for our common house earth. Now, may I ask for your blessing upon our students, faculty, and staff, and all the members of Sophia family. Once again, thank you very much for offering us Your Holiness' precious time. Thank you very much.
And we heard there from Tsukuma Tsutomu, the Chancellor of the Sophia School Corporation, which includes the university and, as he mentioned, a number of other educational institutions.
Cedemos ahora la palabra y nosotros los escuchamos con todo cariño, con toda atención.
And now we'll hear from our Holy Father, Pope Francis, in his final discourse.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas, me alegra mucho poder estar unos minutos con ustedes al final de mi visita apostólica, pero antes de dejar Japón y regresar a Roma.
Dear brothers and sisters, it is a great joy for me to be able to spend a few minutes with you at the conclusion of my apostolic visit, shortly before leaving Japan, and returning to Rome.
Agradezco a Dios y a todo el pueblo nipón por la oportunidad de poder visitar este país.
My stay in this country has been short and very intense, but I'd like to thank God and all of you for the opportunity to visit this country, which St. Francis Xavier so greatly desired to know, and where so many martyrs bore witness to their Christian faith. Despite the fact that Christians are a minority, their presence is felt.
Que se tiene hacia la Iglesia Católica. Y espero que este respeto mutuo pueda
I myself have witnessed the general esteem in which the Catholic Church is held, and I hope that this mutual respect may increase in the future.
Y el orden que caracteriza en la sociedad japonesa, se percibe que se desea y se busca algo más.
I would also observe that for all the efficiency and order that mark Japanese society, I have sensed a yearning too for something greater, a profound desire to create an ever more humane, compassionate, and merciful society.
Y vuestra cultura japonesa está en este sentido orgullosa de su herencia antigua y rica.
Study and meditation are part of every culture, and your Japanese culture is rightly proud of its ancient and rich heritage in this regard. Japan has been able to integrate the thinking and the religions of Asia as a whole, and to create a culture with a well-defined identity. The Ashikaga School, which so impressed St. Francis Xavier, is an example of the capacity of Japanese culture to absorb and to pass on knowledge. Centers of study, meditation, and research continue to play an important role in present-day culture. For this reason, it is important that they preserve their autonomy and freedom for the sake of a better future. Since universities continue to be the primary place where future leaders are trained, it is necessary that a breadth of knowledge and culture inspire every aspect of the life of educational institutions, making them ever more inclusive and capable of generating opportunities and social advancement.
Sofia,
in order to manage our resources in constructive and efficient ways, we have always been in need of true wisdom. In a society as competitive and technologically oriented as present-day Japan, this university, should be a center not only of intellectual formation, but also a place where a better society and a more hope-filled future can take shape. In the spirit of my encyclical Laudato Si, I would add that love for nature, so typical of Asian cultures, should here find expression in a sapient and foresighted concern for the protection of the earth, our common home. A concern that can join in the promotion of a new episteme that can provide a broader vision as opposed to the reductionism born of the technocratic paradigm. It's a citation from Laudato Si. Let us not forget that an authentic humanity calling for a new synthesis seems to dwell in the midst of our technological culture, almost unnoticed, like a mist seeping gently beneath a closed door. Will the promise last in spite of everything, with all that is authentic rising up in stubborn resistance? That again from Laudato Si. Sofia University has always been marked by a humanistic, Christian, and international identity. From its foundation, the university has been enriched by the presence of professors from various countries, even at times from countries in conflict with one another. Yet all were united by the desire to give the best of themselves to the young people of Japan. The same spirit continues in the many ways that you provide help to those in greatest need, here and abroad.
De que este aspecto de la identidad de vuestra universidad se fortalecerá cada vez más.
I am confident that this aspect of your university's identity will grow ever stronger, so that today's great technological advances can be put at the service of a more humane, just, and ecologically responsible education.
La tradición ignaciana en la que se basa Sofía debe impulsar a profesores y estudiantes por igual.
The Ignatian tradition on which Sofía is based ought to inspire professors and students alike to create an atmosphere that fosters reflection and discernment.
Ningún estudiante de esta universidad debería graduarse sin haber aprendido cómo elegir.
No student of your university should graduate without having learned how to choose responsibly and freely what he or she knows in conscience is best. In every situation, even the most complex, may they be concerned that their conduct is just and humane, conscientious and responsible, and show themselves resolute defenders of the vulnerable. May they be known for the integrity so greatly needed in these times, when words and actions are often misleading or deceitful.
Que propuso la Compañía de Jesús dejan claro que el acompañamiento de los jóvenes es
the universal apostolic preferences that the Society of Jesus proposed and that I approved this year make it clear that the accompaniment of young people is an important priority worldwide.
La Iglesia Universal también mira con esperanza
and that all Ignatian institutions must foster that accompaniment. As evidenced by the Synod on Youth and its documents, the Universal Church likewise looks with hope and interest to young people worldwide. Your university as a whole ought to focus on the young, who should not only receive excellent education, but also be part of that education, offering their insights and sharing their vision and hopes for the future.
Y por el enriquecimiento y vitalidad.
May your university be known for such a model of sharing and for the enrichment and vitality that it generates.
La university está totalmente en consonancia con la otra de las preferencias que mencioné.
Sofía's Christian and humanistic tradition is fully consonant with yet another of the preferences that I mentioned, namely that of walking with the poor and the outcasts of our world. The university, focused on its mission, should always be open to creating an archipelago capable of connecting realities that might be considered culturally and socially separate. Marginalized will be creatively incorporated into the life and curriculum of the university, in an effort to bring about an educational approach aimed at reducing distances and disconnects.
El estudio universitario de calidad, más que considerado el privilegio de unos pocos, tiene que ir acompañado por la conciencia de saberse servidores de la justicia y del bien común.
Quality university education should not be the privilege of a few, but constantly informed by the effort to serve justice and the common good, a service to be carried out by each one in the sector in which he or she is called to work. This is a concern that regards everyone. Peter's advice to Paul remains true today, that we not forget the poor, a reference to Galatians chapter 2.
Queridos todos los que trabajan en la Sofía University.
Dear young people, professors and staff of Sofía University.
Den fruto en sus vidas y en las de esta comunidad académica.
May these reflections and our meeting today bear fruit for your lives and for the life of this academic community. The Lord and His Church are counting on you to share in the mission of seeking, finding, and spreading divine wisdom, and thus offering joy and hope to present-day society. Please remember, too, to pray for me and for all those most in need of our help. And now, as I prepare to leave Japan, I thank you, and through you, the entire Japanese people, for the kind reception and welcome accorded me during my apostolic visit. And I will keep all of you in my heart and in my prayers. Thank you very much. That was the address of our Holy Father, Pope Francis, speaking at Sophia University in Tokyo. And concluding with a word of gratitude and affection for the community and for all of Japan.
De parte de todos los alumnos y los profesores de la universidad.
And the university is presenting a gift to the Holy Father on the part of all the alumni of the university.
Le explico cuál es el contenido del regalo que le vamos a hacer. Esta escultura que le queremos regalar es en realidad originalmente la escultura de la diosa Kanon, que es la diosa budista de la misericordia. Como se parece a una estatua de la Virgen María, los cristianos de Nagasaki durante la persecución la utilizaban para rezar sin ser descubiertos.
Of Our Lady of Mercy,
que tiene esta escultura que le regalamos, es que está ennegrecida por el humo de las velas o probablemente el incienso,
which was used by the martyrs during the times of persecution as an object to assist them in prayer.
Tiene un niño en los brazos, cosa no demasiado común en este tipo de esculturas y que la hace todavía parecerse más a una escultura de la Virgen con el niño. La escultura, la estatua, probablemente proviene del sur de China, de allí pasó a Japón.
And a very beautiful sculpture,
a
very distinctive Japanese style.
Y para que uniendo su corazón al de los mártires, no se olvide de rezar por todos nosotros.
And a very beautiful gift on the part of university to our Holy Father. And the Holy Father accepts that and takes a moment to admire it.
Este es finalmente un regalo de parte del Papa Francisco a la Universidad de Sofía.
And the Holy Father likewise offers a gift to the university. It is a silver image of the Madonna, a bas-relief of the artist Marino Mandolesi, who was directly inspired by the famous painting of the Immaculate Conception that Scipio Puzzoni had made in 1582 for the chapel in the town of Gaeta, which is dedicated to the Immaculate Conception. And in fact, in front of the original painting, Pope Pius IX, Blessed Pope Pius IX, was accustomed to pray during his stay as an exile in Gaeta when he had been driven out of Rome during the revolutionary movements. The revolutionary movement of the Roman Republic, the so-called Roman Republic in 1848. He was in exile for several years. And in fact, it was precisely at Gaeta that in 1849, Pius IX wrote the encyclical letter Ubi Primum, in which he consulted the Catholic Episcopate on the definition of the dogma of the Immaculate Conception. So a strong history there. Just a few years later, having received the testimony of the local churches throughout the world through their bishops, the Holy Father, Blessed Pius IX, of course, defined formally the dogma of the Immaculate Conception of Mary, an ex cathedra definition that is infallible. And so this Marian image, the reproduction in a silver bas-relief, is very significant precisely because it did inspire, at least in some ways, the definition of the Immaculate Conception.
Le agradecemos nuevamente de todo corazón haber podido estar con nosotros y la verdad que es una bendición grande para la universidad. Muchísimas gracias. Ah, no, no, no. ¿Saludar a la gente? Sí, sí, cómo no. Sí, sí, está bien. Vamos por acá. Pasemos por acá que hay escalera. Quito a Isaac, si está acá.
And the Holy Father concludes his visit. He's able to greet a few of the students as he leaves. And you can always tell the Holy Father really lights up when he has the opportunity to meet with people. Some of the events can be very formalized, but he always is very enthusiastic when he does go out and greet the faithful, greet those who wish to see him and speak with him. And we see that again here today. As we mentioned, this is the final day of Pope Francis' visit to Southeast Asia. He began his trip last week in Thailand, and after several days in Thailand, came here to Japan. Earlier this morning, the Holy Father celebrated the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass privately with members of the Society of Jesus, the Jesuits, in the chapel at the Sophia University. And he also had a chance to visit with elderly and ill priests who are associated with the university. The Holy Father, after this stop here at Sophia University, will be headed to the Tokyo airport for the farewell ceremony. And in just a few hours' time, will be departing by plane back to Rome. Once again, we thank all of you for listening in, and we thank you for those of you who have listened in over the past couple of days. We do invite you to visit our website at www.vaticannews.va for full coverage of the event with text of the Holy Father's speeches and pictures and videos of the events over the past 8 days. Once again, I'd like to thank all of those listening in on our partner stations and organizations, including Radio Luce, We Are One Body Radio, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Catholic TV, and CBS News. My name is Christopher Wells. You have been listening to Vatican News live coverage of the papal voyage to Southeast Asia, to Thailand and Japan. Thank you once again. And as always, praise be Jesus Christ. Laudetur Jesus Christus.
Security 上の理由により、今しばらくこのままお席でお座りのままお待ちくださいますようお願いいたします。